Hello viewers, in today's class we are going to discuss on radiation mechanism for two wire antenna. So in my previous class I have explained about radiation mechanism in single wire. This is continuation for that. So you can see in this diagram we have taken a AC source followed by two transmission pair of lines, and here we have antenna structure. We can just see an example here. If I remove off this tapering portion, this part is simply a transmission line. So for transmission line, just what is the thing we do? At one end we give supply, other end we connect to a load, and it will be closed. But here the concept for antennas is always this end should be opened. So for antenna, basically the other end should be opened and another side we will be having a source. From this diagram I'm going to explain the two wire mechanism of an antenna. You can see clearly here I have used AC source only, never used DC for antennas. Why? Because we should be able to produce some alternating current, then only it is possible to have radiation outward. And see, you are going to start from this end. So first, after applying the source from this end, what happens is the electric field develops between these two pair of lines. So actually this is one conductor, this is another conductor, and after this source is applied, immediately what happens between these two conductors, the field lines will be formed like this. And now you can observe clearly the positive and negative charges are formed like this. The signal will be propagating like this, from positive towards negative, again negative towards positive, again positive towards negative. You can see here I have drawn an AC waveform, right? So the frequency of this waveform will exactly match to the frequency what we have chosen here. We may be always getting it out how it is possible to get the output from the antenna for different frequencies. The reason behind this is whatever the source we take here, according to that the field lines will be developed between these two pair of conductors. That means if, for example, here we have taken high frequency waveform, automatically the field lines becomes closed. If I take a low frequency waveform, the field lines gets more separated. According to that your output will be changing. Now we will come back to our point. Okay, I have applied a source here. Immediately what has happened? This part is one conductor, this part is another conductor. Actually, what a conductor consists of? Atoms, right? Like this. Again, inside the atom what we have? Free electrons, right? So inside each and every atom we have available free electrons. Here what will happen is such type of electrons are present throughout this conductor. What does these field lines do? They will go and apply force on this free available electrons. Immediately what happens, if they start pushing, these free electrons displace from this point to here, and again they start displacing from here to here. Like that, throughout this conductor the flow of current starts. Because of this current flow, the electric field is created in this direction, right? The electric field will be created in this direction, and these field lines will be having the tangential position according to this electric field. And now as this electric field is continuously changing, why? Because I am using AC source here. Automatically we know that change in electric field produces change in magnetic field, like this. So these two will be always mutually perpendicular. Now the electric current passes along this direction. Up to here we can clearly see that just the current is following this path as it is, like a guided transmission. But what happens after this point? Now just we have taken example of three field lines only, but actually it can be more. It depends on the number of available free electrons in this conductors, both of the conductors we are having, right? So just for our understanding, we have taken three lines. So like this, three positive and three negative we have shown. You need to observe one point here. The waveform we are shown like this is nothing but the positive moving towards negative, negative moving towards the positive, just like this. So after crossing this point, what happens to this radio waves or electromagnetic waves? Now we'll see from this diagram. You can see here, after crossing this point, what has happened? Observe clearly here, these three field lines, going in the upward direction, I have drawn here. These three free lines coming in downward direction, I have drawn here, right? So now we know that opposite charges gets attracted. So exactly after entering into the free space, this two gets combined like this. They form a closed loop like this. Why? Because if you observe clearly, they get flowing in the same direction. After entering into this free space, this thing automatically happens, and you can't imagine, this is very, very, very quick operation. We can't imagine the time. Very quickly, they form like closed circular loops. You can now observe, this is entirely a single loop. See here, we don't know even where the waveform has started and where it has ended. That means they will be forming the closed loops like this. Just closed loops like this. We don't know the starting point. We don't know the ending point. Usually things will be said that always we have the travel of a signal from positive towards a negative like that. But looking these loops, we cannot say where the signal has started, where the where it has ended. Simply they will be appearing in our free space like this. These waveforms start their journey in free space and they propagate away like this towards the receiving antenna. So why these closed loops have formed? Just look here. Now here, three negatives are there, three positives are there. So this positive gets attracted towards this negative. This positive gets attracted towards this negative like this in the same way. And these are forming closed loops in the free space. But if they are present along the wire, this can't happen. Why? Because they are bounded to the wire. But if they enter into the free space, there is nothing to control them. There is nothing to bound for them. So they become free. And immediately they form the closed loops like this. So this is very, very simple two-wire mechanism concept where we have just extended a transmission line into an antenna. If you go for the concept of transmission line, what happens is this will not be present. So if this part is absent, this just acts like a normal transmission line where we have a load at the other end and all the signal will be propagated along these lines and that will be collected at the load. The only thing what we have done is we have not connected any load here. Simply we have left the other end free and propagates along this path like this. And via here, it reaches the end of the lines. And from here, it gets detached from the antenna like this. These radio waves start propagating in the free space. So after ending from this point, there will be control on these waves. They just combine in free space like this and they start moving away. For our appearance, it will be like that. How this can happen with a lower time means it will happen like that. Why? Because it takes very, very little bit of time for these two things to combine and propagate in the free space. Here, one more important thing you have to keep in mind is, here, even though after some time, after generating like this, if I remove this source also, these radio waves will be propagated up to certain amount of time like that only, without the source. That means in the absence of source also, the signals will be propagating like this for certain amount of time. That is one of the things you have to keep in mind. Why? Because this source is exactly essential first for initially for generation of this field. Once the field disturbance is created in the conductors, automatically for certain amount of time, this process will be continuously happening. Okay. So this is a concept of radiation mechanism for two-wire antenna. Thanks for watching this video. Thank you.